This will be a quick one. I'm going to show you how you can get RDP or remote desktop access to your Azure machine in the cloud through a Mac or even your your iPhone. It's really simple. Let's walk through it right now. Now here on the Mac, it's kind of stupid easy. You're going to go to the App Store, and wouldn't you know, Microsoft has an RDP app. Search for Microsoft Remote Desktop. There it is right there. Just install that sucker. Now I already have it installed. I'm just going to open it. Now as you can see, I've used this before. I use it all the time actually. Let me show you how to add a connection for your Azure Windows 11 machine in the cloud. Now first it's going to start with Azure, right? So we'll go back to our portal here. Jump back into our Bernard Windows 11 machine. You would have named yours something different. Mine is currently running. And what I want to see is the public IP address. This guy right here. I'm gonna need that. So here in my MacBook, I'll click the plus icon for add desktop or workspace. I'll say add PC, and here's where I'll put the IP address of my PC, which was 20.127.211.189. Give it a friendly name, Bernard Windows. And really that's all we have to do right now. Now you could add a saved user account. I'm not gonna do that right now. I like to enter them in each time. It's a weird thing I do. I don't know. It's my preference. Click on add. And then now that is added in there, all we have to do is double click this. Now because this Windows machine in the cloud has a public IP address, you can access the sucker from anywhere. It's public. So go ahead and double click that. Put your username and password that you set up in the first step of actually setting up your Azure portal machine. Mine was Bernard Hackwell. And then the password. Continue. Continue. And it looks like we're off to the races. Quick little coffee break here. There it is. This is awesome. So just like that, I've got, you know, Windows on my Mac, but I'm using the Microsoft cloud. And that's a little bit cooler, I think. Now on the iPhone, it's remarkably similar. We're gonna go to the App Store. We'll search for Microsoft Remote Desktop. There it is. It's actually called Remote Desktop Mobile, but if you get in there, you can see it's actually made by Microsoft Corporation, so you're nice and you feel good about it anyway. Oh, I need to update mine. So I'll go ahead and update mine. You install yours. Whew, that was quick. Thank you, fast internet. Let's go ahead and open that app. And it's pretty much the same story here. Man, I have a lot of virtual machines that date back throughout my IT history. I kind of love it. Anyways, we're going to click on the add icon in the middle. And looks kind of familiar, doesn't it, from the Mac example. Yeah, let's allow it to find devices, whatever. I'll add a PC. Host name is the IP address once more. Give it a friendly name. And save. Where'd it go? Oh, there it is. So now it's saved. I'm just going to launch it just like before. It's going to ask me for a username and password. Now what's happening here is kind of killer because you could practice Windows from your phone with whatever you're doing. This is why I love this method using the Azure portal because it's a Windows machine you can access anywhere. It's not very expensive. Actually, I left this machine open for like over 24 hours. I got charged like a couple dollars. Not a big deal. And I wasn't charged. It was the free tier, right? But yeah, I mean here, I've got Windows and you can do pretty much anything we're gonna show you in this course. That's awesome. Coffee break to that. I'll see you in the next episode.
You made it to the end of the video. If you want to see the rest of Windows Fundamentals and more great courses like it, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.